Hello students. Today I will tell you about the gene therapy and its role. The question is, what is gene therapy? Why we need the gene therapy? If you consider the pedigree analysis, in case of the pedigree analysis, what will be happening? If the alleles are in the same chromosomes, they transmit in the same way. If the alleles are in the different chromosomes, they transmit in the cross manner. In the same way, the transmission of the disease from one generation to the another generation, such as there are a lot of number of the diseases such as cystic fibrosis, Hutchinson's disease, thalassemia, Alzheimer's, and so on. This brings a concept that who is responsible for such type of disease, as well as the transmission of such disease from one generation to the another generation. Such type of the ideas ignites the brains of the scientists, and they think more about the genes. With the help of some Holger markers, such as the restriction fragment length for morphisms and the single sequence STS, single tandem repeats, these sequences, they confine to that particular gene. Suppose that if you're talking about the, in case of the some cancers, that BRCA genes, they recognize that basically that gene is present in the chromosome number 17, and they recognize at first the size of that genes. And after the STS sequence, they find out the more accurate results regarding to that genes. That gene is causing some breast cancers and ovarian cancers also. Nowadays, if you talk about that this genetic material, as we all are known about that, DNA is genetic materials, and this DNA, it travels along of the distance at the gene or the segment of the DNA. Basically, this idea is coming out in 1972 by the conceptualization of a disease that is the SCID, severe combined immunodeficiency disease. What will be happening that a gene that is the adenosine deaminase gene, the mutated forms of this gene, the truncated form of this gene, causes a disease in the patients that is severe combined immunodeficiency disease, SCID. And whenever they fructify, they replace to that the mutated that genes by its wild copy in the patients in 1990, and they get fruitful results. And after getting these fruitful results, the scientist goes towards the gene therapy by using the recombinant DNA technology. So basically, this concept was limited to the monogenetic disorders. Monogenetic disorders means whenever a single gene causes the disease, but in case of the polygenic disorders, again it is a problems. So now you will see that we will learn more about to these in case of the gene therapy. So now what will be the gene therapy? Basically, the gene therapy is to replace the truncated gene by its wild copy. Here is the two terms. If you're talking about the wild copy means is a original copy of the gene. And mutated copy means it is a truncated copy, or it is not like a wild copy. Whenever we are replacing to that mutated copy by wild copy, then what will be happening? The wild copy expressed to its original expression, and that expression will comes to the patients. Ultimately, the patients will be curable. But there are some ethical problems and other things are also associated to this one. If we talk about in case of the gene therapy is basically two types. That is the germline gene therapy, and second is the somatic gene therapy. When we are using to the replacement of the gene in the germline cells, so then what will be happening? These diseases, then at first we will take the embryo Then we insert to the wild copy of that genes to that embryo in vitro fertilization process. Then we transplant it to again to that that blastocyst in the uterus of the mother. Then what will be happening? That should be curable, and the next generation would be curable. Now it has some ethical problems also. Again, the somatic genes, in case of somatic gene therapy, suppose that if you're talking about the thalassemia, we can replace to that specific gene by the wild copy, then introduce to that gene in the somatic cells. That comes in the somatic gene therapy. So we need a lot of the number of vectors for said gene therapy. There are two types of the vectors. One is the viral based vectors and one other is the non-viral based vectors. The question is, who will transfer to that gene, to that particular place. For transferring to that particular gene, we need some vectors. So regarding to this vector, that vectors are categorized in two categories. One is the viral based vector, other one is non-viral based vector. Here you will see here that the delivery of that gene, the delivery of that DNA by using the virus age. However, we all are known about that viruses are pathogenic in nature. They are causing the disease too. But before using the viruses as a vector, what we will do? We will modify to these viruses, and we can reduce the pathogenicity of their diseases. Only that viruses just only they act as a vector. So here it is a common strategy. It is a common strategy that, what is that common strategy? The common strategy is to remove to those essential genes which are required for the replication of virus inside the cells. Because virus are the connecting link between non-living and living things. Whenever these viruses enters in the cells, in the living cells, they replicate to its machine, they replicate to its genome by using the machinery of that living cells. So for that process, in the laboratory process, what we will do, at first our job is to remove to those essential genes which are responsible for the replication process in case viruses, as well as our job is to remove to those genes which are responsible for the pathogenesis. That means our first job is to modify that virus in the form of non-replicative, non-pathogenic virus. Then this is a first important point, that at first our job is, if the virus are, we are using a viral vector in gene therapy, so our first job is to modify that viral genome, and that so that viral genome will becomes a non-replicative, non-pathogenic virus. Now these non-replicative, non-pathogenic viruses are used in gene therapy as vectors, such as retroviruses, adenoviruses. For example, retroviruses are used, adenoviruses are used, adeno-associated viruses, as well as the herpes simplex viruses. These viruses are used in gene therapy as viral vectors. Now what will be happening? Most of these viruses enter through the cells by using specific receptors, because the receptors are present in the cells. And these viruses codes some signal molecules. These signal molecules will bind to the specific receptors of these cells, and therefore it is a tough task that how can we target that specific type of cell? How can we target might not be suitable for targeting all types of the cells, because the specific receptors, the viruses enter cells using a specific receptors. If the receptors are not present in the cells, so these cells will be not targeted by these viruses. Only those cells will be targeted which cells has the specific receptors for binding to these non-replicative, non-pathogenic viruses. Now you will see here that in case of the four vectors, what are the four vectors? That are the retroviruses, adenoviruses. Number one is retroviruses, number two is adenoviruses, number three is adeno-associated viruses, and number four is herpes simplex virus. The four vector, the retroviral vector is the most broad range of viruses are available for using the gene therapy. So now these viral vectors will be engineered for the expression of that ligand, for the expression of that ligand or signal molecule for that specific receptors, because the receptors are present in the cells. So the viruses will be modified in such a way for expressing to such type of ligands according to the need of these receptors. Thus, so they converted to narrow specificity to the broad specific vectors. By this genetic modification in the viruses, these narrow specificity of these viruses will be changed into the broad specificity. What this type of strategy, this type of strategy is known as pseudotyping, which is an important process. Pseudotyping is an important process. Now the question is, student, what is pseudotyping? So your answer will be that whenever we are modified the virusage, in such a way for the expression of such type of ligands which are specific to the receptors, which are specific to the receptors, and because basically these receptors are present in the virusage, and such type of the modification will change the specificity of these viruses narrow towards to the broad specificity. Such type of strategy is known as pseudotyping. Pseudo means chuta, typing. Here is it, typing, pseudotyping, because this is non-natural. So this unnatural process, if in natural, why I'm using the unnatural process? Because this type of modification occurs in the laboratory process in the genome as that viral vectors. I think that you understand the concept of this viral-based vectors. Then we will come to the next, non-viral vectors. Here is this some retroviruses. There is a retroviral vectors. We are come to the retroviral vectors. Retroviruses are, the genome of retroviruses is RNA. Their genome is RNA-based genomes.